Hello guys, welcome back to our channel, The Collector's Hub. Let's continue our survival drive in this strange place. If you like this kind of game and would like us to continue with it, give this video a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.
Welcome to our program, the assistant to the general manager of the Section 1 Northern Facility, Dr. Ken Washington. Welcome.
Happy to be here.
Dr. Washington, I understand that you've lived here in the zone for some time.
My chief location was joining the regulatory commission with it, but one technology moved the hands of the people. After 2 decades, it's time to share what we've learned, the utter magic of what we've been able to create with Olympic.
And that's all taking place with something you're calling the wind there.
That's right. We're bringing the wonder of wind waves to the residential scale. One lucky town on the Olympic Peninsula will be gifted the government-sponsored buildings and all the latest in technology. Imagine the power of quantum oscillodynamics, nanomineralization, and like further behind the culture. How about that?
That's a lot of
scary and
power
terms,
but what does it all
mean? Whatever you want. That limit will work with you to choose what wind tech best fits your personal and professional goals.
Okay, so you said that only one lucky time that can get. So how will you pick up the town?
Nice catch. We're inviting all towns within 50-mile radius in the zone to apply. Send your application. Tell us what your town is all about. And what LinTech could do for you. You've got until November 20th to send in your entry, and I'll be reviewing them all myself. So I'm really looking forward to hearing from you.
All right, you heard it here. Apply early and apply often.
Awesome.
Good luck.
Oh, no. caught up in it. friend. Welcome to our side of the wall. Oh, what's this? Your connection to Wampy is jammed? Worry not. Our signal is crystal clear.
A little bit obvious, don't you think?
Right, ask me if I can. Yeah, the mid-zone's been marinating in all this radiation for so long. Things don't work the same as they do in the outer zone. But the good news is, we live here. We can help you, no sweat.
First things first, we've got to extend the signal from the garage. Otherwise, Obby's equipment won't be much help. Hooking you into a mid-zone stabilizer should do the trick. Look around. You should be able to see one up a hill somewhere.
Thank you.
Francis, pan the car's broadcast frequency to the stabilizer, would you? Hey, come on, I can't do this without you.
Fine. There. Your receiver's hooked in now.
And we're patched into all that sweet ARC device data. Nice work. Oppie won't be able to block us out anymore. Well, better get going.
Here it comes.
Security locked in. Try that overload code for the observation tower.
message. Hold the phone. You show the prince bobbleheads? What?
Some grand scheme, don't you?
Let me get this straight. You hijacked my mission, tapped into my frequency, and now you want to be all buddy-buddy. Not on your life. You think you're hot stuff. Why don't you take the lead, then? Get the driver through all by your damn selves.
Did she just hang up on us? Well, guess it's our time to shine. So, Francis, you got any ideas?
We know the driver needs to get to the deep zone, but it's too dangerous to head there directly. We have to zero in on exactly where to go. The signal amplification trick won't work here. The ambient instability is too strong in the mid-zone.
Huh, how indeed. There was one other time where the mass hallucination and the remnants intersected. Driver, I've tagged a route for you. Whenever you're ready, give it a spin.
Coverage of limb technology is bright-eyed and bushy-tailed at first. In the decade between 1955 to 1965, limb is called many things. The promise of the future, the herald of a new age, the never spoken of again. You don't have to dig very deep for the gaps in the story to emerge. The presidential demonstration is the only physical proof we ever see of it. Compared to the Manhattan Project, developed under airtight shroud of secrecy, why was Lim paraded around in the papers? And if it really was the technological quantum leap to answer all our wildest dreams, why did it blink out of existence? The story of Lim technology is one hell of a maze, and the key to it is a woman named Dr. Ophelia Turner. Did Ophelia Turner, by all measure a failed physicist as far as her public record goes, truly invent Lim technology? Or was she held up as a Rosie the Riveter for the Cold War? An atomic Annie to excite the masses during the no-holds-barred race against the Soviet Union? Was she a myth, martyr, or monster? A figment of the imagination? True savior? Or a convenient scapegoat? I'm Chiaki Saruhashi, and in this 9-part series, I aim to find out. Welcome back. This is Frequency File, Episode 2. In the last episode, I told you about the curious case of Dr. Ophelia Turner. When it comes to this enigmatic individual, one of three versions is true. Myth, martyr, or monster. To be able to weigh her in turns as heretic, genius, or scapegoat, we must first set the stage. When I started down this path to discover who she was, what she did, and ultimately what happened to her, I didn't expect it to lead me to one of the strangest mysteries of the Pacific Northwest, the Olympic Exclusion Zone. But let me rewind a bit. In Northwest Washington State, there are 3,600 square miles of vibrant wilderness called the Olympic Peninsula. Bounded by water on three sides, it was a wonderland for outdoorsy types, with snow-capped mountains and salmon-bearing rivers and pristine rainforests. Up until 1955, it was the residence of 100,000 people, including Ophelia Turner. It was her birthplace, her hometown, and, it turns out, ground zero and sacrificial lamb for the promise of Lim technology. In true fashion, the government never comes out and says that's what led to the creation of the Olympic Exclusion Zone. But the chain of events were in plain sight. Strange accidents, leading to the government's claim of eminent domain and subsequent seizure of the peninsula. The evacuation of 100,000 people and the attempt and abject failure at containing the rumors that spread like wildfire. Because it turns out, even with the government's resources at your disposal, keeping secrets is a tricky business. You can bet there was plenty of talk as a result. Lucky me, because I had plenty of questions.
Thank you. Thank you.